I'm Nick DeLorme, CEO of Sellozo. A computer science degree from Purdue, kind of a tech nerd, definitely. So I've spent basically the last 13 years of my life building automated and massively scalable online advertising systems. So everything from like behavioral targeting systems to real-time bidding systems. And about a year ago, I was approached about this position at Sellozo, about taking over the CEO of this role. And at first, I was kind of like, "Are you sure you want a nerd to come in here and run this thing?" But they were at a point where they're building a lot of technology. It's very product focused. There's a lot of innovation going on in the space, and they wanted us to kind of build something that just made or the idea around Sellozo was to build something that's easier for people to do sponsored product ads, for Amazon sellers. And it's an interesting space because. The people that are selling, it's everybody from an individual seller to larger businesses, but a lot of people are the very small business, the one guy at home trying to make it work, or one girl at home trying to make it work, or just a couple employees. And they really rely on tools and different things to help them scale their business. And the PPC is, it's not trivial. It's easy to go in there and sort of launch a campaign. It's hard to make it work. It's hard to sort of get the auto campaign launched, the manual campaign launched. What is an ad group? What's a keyword? What's a negative keyword? And so we were kind of like, well, why can't we build a tool that just makes it so that they can choose the products they want to advertise, tell us what the margin they want to have on it, and just let us launch these campaigns for them? So, that's what Sellozo was sort of born from, is the concept of trying to create a simpler way and a better way for people to manage this. And even for the larger businesses, that have, say, thousands of products, at that point, it almost becomes impossible to, manually manage keyword bids, individually. I mean, you have to have some sort of automation, some sort of algorithm to be appropriately bidding on all of your bids and sort of detecting new search terms. And so, myself and a couple of the engineers that started this, since we had this background in advertising and we knew a lot about how to build these optimization systems anyway, so we're like, well, let's just bring some of those algorithms into this to make it easier. And that's what we did. So, the MVP, the first version of this, kind of went live at the beginning of this year. And it was a pretty simple platform where, yeah, basically they could do what I said. It would launch the campaigns for them. It would automate the bids. When, search terms started converting in an auto campaign, we would automatically spawn the manual campaign for people. It'll transfer, winning search terms over into the manual campaign and then be bidding on those keywords automatically. So, it just made it easier. Over the last year, we've had a lot of innovation, kind of went from MVP to a much more, advanced platform where not only are you able to kind of do this automation that we had, but also see how your organic revenue is being impacted by your PPC revenue. So we have like great dashboards and reporting to show true profit and show, as your PPC, revenue is going up, are you seeing corresponding spikes in organic as well at the same time? And other things that we've launched are like day parting. So things that they don't offer in the Amazon system at all, where you're able to say, okay, from midnight to six, I know people are just really not converting. It's kind of wasting my spend. Maybe I'm running out of budget before the day ends. People can turn on day parting so that their campaigns automatically only turn on at, say, 6 o'clock in the morning Eastern time or something. And then it turns itself off at 10 o'clock at night or whatever they want to. That's all configurable in the system. So
Okay.
that's some of the stuff that we've been doing. We started with PPC, but Sellozo is really about tools to help grow your business. What can we do that automates things? What can we do that makes things easier? And that's kind of what we've been building. So.
Okay. So the automated Amazon PPC space is not exactly a quiet one. There's
right.
multiple software companies out there that claim to basically do the exact same thing, more or less. So what
Yeah.
really is the differentiator from you guys to all your other competitors out there?
There's a couple. One of them is that ours is much more fully automated. Most of the systems that are out there will give you recommendations. So they'll kind of analyze your stuff. They'll give you a bunch of stuff that you need to do. You have these big lists of things that you need to accept or apply. So people still need to take this daily task of going in and applying your changes, where ours is much more of automated, more of an automated platform. I'd say the other thing that we do that's much better than other platforms is integrating with the existing campaigns that already are there. So, you know, a lot of people, I'd say 90% of the people that sign up for Sellozo have already at least attempted or have a substantial type of PPC setup already going. Like they've got their own campaign set up, their own ad groups kind of put together the way they want. And we're able to kind of, you know, at the very easiest, they can go on and click a single button that starts optimizing individual campaigns that already exist. We can also link campaigns together. So say they have an auto and a manual campaign already created. They do this thing where they're moving keywords back and forth. We can say, okay, if you've already got those, we can link them in our platform so we don't have to regenerate or relearn any of these things. Other things that we do is we're able to, you know, over the, I guess we see this all the time with accounts, but it tends to sort of explode in the number of campaigns and ad groups and things you've got and the organization that you have. You archive things and you create new ones and you yeah. sort of like try a bunch of stuff. And, you know, most systems only look at a single campaign and the data from that campaign and they try and optimize within that campaign. Where what we do is we try and pull all the data together from all of the campaigns, regardless of whether, you know, if you were running the same product over in campaign A and now you're running campaign B, we still can leverage the data, even if it's archived from campaign A in campaign B, so that you don't have to start from scratch, you know, to start over and learn keywords over again. You know, there's a significant investment to sort of discovering keywords and, you know, learning what works and what doesn't work. So, you know, that was one of the cool things that we wanted to make happen for existing sellers. So
nice. So Amazon advertising in the past 3-4 months has released new stuff almost yep. every few weeks. So a couple weeks ago, maybe a little more than that at this point, the product targeting came mm-hmm. out with sponsored products. And then today I saw the automatic campaigns have now offered like different tiered keywording in there with the different categories and stuff. So like, let's look at the product targeting from that came out a few weeks ago. So is that something you guys are looking into on how to automate that process?
It definitely is. You know, we were, Sellozo was invited to a partner event, you know, a few months ago. So we kind of had a heads up that some of this stuff was coming along. So we've definitely been thinking about how to use it, how to use this ASIN targeting, the category-based targeting. You know, right now, Amazon always tends to sort of launch things where it's available in the UI that you can do things, but it's not available in any kind of automated fashion. So the APIs that support this stuff don't support any of these new targeting methods. But our team is you know, already sort of trained on how to use some of these new features. So, you know, one of the things that was really important for Sellozo is that, you know, we have this SaaS platform and you log in and you can sign up online and you can just get going on your own. But, you know, people usually need more help than that. People usually need somebody to talk to. So, you know, our team, you know, you always have a one-on-one onboarding session with every customer that we have sign up. So you get on the phone, you can talk about it. And at that point, they can talk about, okay, what are the strategies to use ASIN targeting or category targeting for you, you know, before we're able to automate that part. So, you know, day one, when it's available to us, I'm sure we'll be in the beta program for that API. You know, we'll be automating those pieces of it. But in the meantime, that's something that's, you know, talked about in the onboarding, and then our top tier is the ultimate tier, and it's much more managed. So the very bigger accounts, we do all of that stuff for you. So anything that's not able to be automated, we're able to do manually on our side. So,
so the while you're talking about accounts, what is like the ideal, you know, seller to work with you? Because I know you mentioned like mm-hmm. a lot have tried and then failed, so they're probably newer guys who haven't been doing this for a while.
Yep.
And I assume you guys probably have some on the other end of the spectrum. So what really seems to be like the seller that works best with Sellozo?
Right. So, you know, definitely there isn't just one aspect to make selling work. You know, PPC isn't just a silver bullet that you turn it on and all of a yeah. sudden you make more money. you know, you have to have a good listing. You have to have good pictures. You have to have some reviews. You know, the people that come on and do really successful are people that are at least somewhat established. They don't have to be a large seller, but they need to have at least had, you know, a dozen, you know, 10 reviews, have sold a little bit of their product, and have a decent listing. And, you know, at that point, we can definitely help them grow from there. I'd say the people that struggle the worst are the people that come on and they're like, well, I'm just sent in my first product. I haven't had a sale yet. How can I turn on advertising today? And, you know, that's a case where, you know, day one, you know, is not necessarily the best idea. You know, I guess for, you know, there is scenarios where for ranking purposes, so say a private label seller is a really good example where PPC is almost getting to be a requirement where you're coming in with a new product in a category that's existing, you know, there's already going to be products in there that are competing with you. How do you get to the top of the search results? You know, used to be that you could sort of do some organic things. But, you know, over the last year, it's become much more competitive. I mean, there's thousands of sellers signing up every day to sell on Amazon. And, you know, to be at the top of the listings, you have to spend a little bit of advertising money to get your, you know, your new version of the coffee mug or whatever at the top of the listings, to start building your ranks, to start building your organic revenue. So, you know, somebody that's trying to launch a private label, that's a perfect example. Somebody that has a little bit of established sales, you know, that's a perfect person that should be using our platform. And really, you know, we have a completely free version of our platform that gives you this organic versus like your true profit reporting for free. Like you don't have to pay anything. There's no monthly fee or any like limits. You can sign up for Sellozo today and get free reporting that at least at the very least gives you an understanding of what fees am I being charged. You know, you're able to enter in the cost of goods and your inbound sales, inbound shipping costs. And we, you know, basically try and give you what your true profit is on a product over time. So we've built a really amazing platform for people to use that. So I would say, you know, I've got friends of mine that are starting to be sellers. And I say, as soon as you start selling, sign up for Sellozo and at very least use the reporting. You know, once you start going a little bit, then, you know, upgrade to, you know, our basic package and let's start helping you with the advertising. So, you know, at the very least, everybody should just be using it to get better reporting. You know, so
that's a nice added feature. It's interesting because we find the same thing here. Like it really is, it's almost pay to play now. There's very few situations where you might be okay not doing PPC. And usually we find those to be very, if not, it's usually not very established sellers. It's usually a very established brand off Amazon. Seems to be the only ones, because then, you know, you're just fighting for your own brand name. So even then you can do PPC ads where you just do exact match and leave them as is. Mm-hmm. You know, it is definitely becoming a very much a pay to play, and it's becoming more and more competitive because more and more people are realizing that and they're releasing more options. I'm really interested to see how anyone has the ability to automate the product targeting side of things that they just released, just because of picking and choosing which ASINs to go after or which category seems very manual to me. But I'm sure there'll be some data out there that someone will get.
I mean, definitely we definitely have some smart people that have built a lot of algorithms over the years to optimize advertising. So, you know, my philosophy is let's make everything that we can automate, let's automate. Everything that we can't, let's make it as easy as possible to use. Yeah. So, you know, if you, like a lot of the things that we did in the platform to make it easier is we created this thing called the product view, where instead of having to look at login and every platform you log in, you see campaigns, you see ad groups, you see keywords, and there's these tabs, and you can kind of look at these big lists of stuff. We were like, well, why can't you just go in and see like, my baby products and, you know, combine all of that data together and then look at it at a product level. So combine the organic and combine the PPC together so that you sort of have like a cohesive, like, okay, I'm looking at, you know, my 14 baby products. How is that trending over time? How is organic versus PPC working? And then be able to do bulk actions on groups of products. And so our product view is probably, I think it's the only thing out there that allows you to do something like that, that pulls the data together in a way that, you know, for somebody like, you know, my mother or somebody that's trying to sell something on Amazon that doesn't really understand online advertising space, and it's weird and there's weird terminology. Can I just look at products and see, you know, what's working, what isn't working? Can I combine my Christmas stuff together into a what we call smart tags and filter by that Christmas tag and see all of the data, all of the products, everything trends over time, and then be able to take bulk actions, you know, to be able to launch campaigns. You know, maybe I can, you know, some of our customers come in and they look at a product and they can click on, okay, show me my advertising for this product. And they'll see that, oh, well, I was actually advertising this product 14 times in 14 different campaigns. I didn't even realize that. I'm kind of competing against myself. You know, maybe I can clean that up. It gives them a really easy way to understand and see that. So, you know, I think that as Amazon releases new features, as ASIN targeting, category targeting, all the new things that they're adding, they're very bullish in advertising. They're launching, the Amazon DSP is launching. I mean, they're definitely pushing into the advertising space. It's not going to get simpler. It's going to get more complicated every day. And, you know, using tools to help make it easier for the single seller that's at home trying to figure this out is going to be critical, I think, for people. Because Amazon isn't there to make it easy. They're able to sort of create all these features and create all these possibilities. And it's up to us to try and figure out, okay, what works, what doesn't work. how can we boil this down and make it consumable for, you know, the average seller. So,
okay. So 2019, what do you think is going to happen in the Amazon PPC world?
Well, I guess in the Amazon PPC world, it's definitely going to get more competitive. I mean, prices are going up. We can see that in our data. You know, more sellers are coming in. That's pretty straightforward. You know, they'll continue to do different targeting options. You know, slowly they'll roll out new things in the API. You know, I think for Sellozo, you know, we're going to go – our business wasn't designed necessarily to be only PPC. We wanted to make automation something that was, how do we just help grow businesses in all aspects? So, you know, one of the things we'll be launching is a repricer, you know, helping arbitrage, you know, people trying to automate and hit that buy box. We've got some really cool reporting in our platform right now. That's free actually, that will show you over time what buy box percentage you have and what days you're red and what days you're green, about how much you're actually getting that buy box, and that updates in real time. In our system. So we're going to leverage that data, be able to build and automate a repricer for people. You know, just making it easier to scale businesses. I think, you know, we're going to see people, Walmart, you know, is launching their, you know, platform. It's very in its infancy. The APIs are very rough, but making it so that why can't you have a platform like Sellozo where you can log in and say, okay, I want to launch all my advertising on eBay, on Walmart, on Google, and have it all managed and all the stats come in together. And I think that's the vision that I see Sellozo going towards in 2019, is automating what can be automated and, you know, making it easier for people to understand and grow their business so that they can focus on sourcing, they can focus on writing those great listings, they can focus on taking better pictures, you know, they can focus on other aspects of the business and let some of the things that can be automated be automated, you know. So, yeah.
Nice. Well, I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, especially for taking time out of your Friday.
No worries.
This will end up on YouTube and our blog and all that fun stuff. So would you mind letting everyone know how they can find more information about you guys, where they can find you? And that should wrap us up.
Sounds good. Thanks a lot for having us on.
Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate it, buddy.
Yeah. Talk to you.
Have a good one.